Oh, there's Garrett. That must be Garrett. He was in this. He was in chat earlier. Are you here, Garrett? Garrett's brand new. Let's play our lucky song for Garrett. And for everybody in the break. Somebody's going to be a champion. Maybe it's a new guy. Maybe it's a veteran. Maybe it's you. Good luck. There they are, number 8. Good luck. This song needs a good rapper. Anybody know someone?
Born champion. The C is for the courage I possess through the trauma. H is for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A is for my attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so the M is for motivation. Gotta stay consistent, the P is to persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O is optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start. They say that every champion is all about his principles. Carry.
And with their near perfect season, the San Francisco 49ers are going back to the Super Bowl. Yes, they are. Apparently the Bears are still in the hunt. Thing is, isn't everybody in the hunt? I mean, that's ridiculous when they show that. I understand wild card leaders, but then they got in the hunt over here. And it's like, they've been in the hunt since week one, dude. I mean, what are they hunting? A playoff spot in front of the other, like, 8 teams? No, not going to happen. I guess there's a difference between mathematically eliminated like the Giants this weekend. Yeah, I have some Vlad and Harper cards from National Baseball Card Day. If you're a big fan, if you're like a true collector, not somebody who just wants these cards to flip them or sell them or whatever, hoard them for later usage to sell. If you're a big fan of Vlad, you don't have one of those cards, I will get you some. Well, you live in Oklahoma, Robert, or you used to or like them, so that also makes sense. But in exchange for the Vlad, you have to tell us about yourself, G-Cope. You got to tell me how you found TSB. You got to tell us if you're experienced in breaking or if this is your first break ever in the world. You got to tell us where you live. Oh, yeah, in Oklahoma, you don't know what rap music is. It's okay. I understand that everybody could grow up on the East Coast like I did, just an hour and a half from Philly, New York, Baltimore, Jersey, stuff like that. It was surrounded by the hip-hop culture as a youth growing up. Many of you were robbed from that opportunity in the inset and the onset of the hip-hop culture, beginning in the mid to late 70s and rolling through the 80s into the 90s and today. So I do understand for those of you who are in towns like Kansas City, Oklahoma, that really don't have a full grasp and understanding of hip-hop culture. It's okay. It's okay. Spectra, no. Oh, very cool. Well, welcome. Thanks for sharing. Welcome to the crew. I'm Chris. I'm the owner of this joint. That guy in chat, Carter, he's the unofficial secondary owner, but he doesn't get paid or make a dime to do anything. I just go to his town every once in a while and take up these wonderful meat sticks from my city, and he trades for that. Well, I was born in Rochester. True story, I was born in Rochester. I think we only stayed there for a couple of months, but I was born. It was all dope growing up. I was like, yeah, I was born in New York, man. I'm from New York. Rochester. And I was there for the first 2 months of my life. '99er Yachty. So who'd you get there? You got... Wait, are you Garrett? Yeah, Garrett, GC. You got the Mets. You get some Pete Alonso action. So do you see how the triple teamer works, Garrett? You're going to be in the same spot each time. So you're going to be in five down there. So you got the A's and the Pirates. So I do it tiered style, so you're guaranteed a top 10 team. See, you get one of these. Pete Alonso, number to 150. So, Chadwick, you've been here for a while. A serial number break. This is a perfect example. So, everyone's going to get a number 0 to 9. Every single card in Spectra is numbered, right? It's numbered. So, I random 0 through 9. 10 spots, 0 through 9. Let's say you were to draw the 4. If you had the 4, you would get this card because it's a 4 right before the slash number. It's always the last number. If this was 112 of 150, the 2 spot, the person with the 2 would get this card. If it was 117 of 150, the person with the 7 would get the spot. So it's all determined on what that serial number is. Obviously, everyone wants the 1 because that's the 1 of 1 spot. Meat stick Carter. Oh, man. Yeah, he just loves his beef and cheese. Rizzo. Well, sure, man. He's rookie of the year, right? That Pete Alonso fella? No, you got into something better. Jeez, man, I'd be a millionaire if I charged that kind of price for Prism, dude. That's like double the price, Chadwick. Jeez, maybe I need to increase my prices. Do what else I see on the internet out there with pricing. No, dude, this is for a half a case of freaking Spectra. That's monstrous. And I would love to charge whatever it is, $1,300 for a half a case of of Prism. Here you go. Good luck. Who could it be now? There's Michael. DJ Stewart plays for the O's, hun. The Orioles are owned by Shawnee Mac. We're going to do our filler next. I don't know what else is on the side. I think it got some XRism or Prismatic XR. Carter came up with that one. Wow. Really? Wow. I don't know. There's a 99 Big Poppy. I do love these old uniforms of the Stros. I think they have some of the best. Does anybody else have any dope uniforms from the 80s like that? That stands out that you can think back and think, wow, I remember those uniforms from those years. White Sox. Goldschmidt, yeah, he looks weird as a Cardinal, doesn't he? He's one of those players that doesn't look right in another uniform. Like, you know, when Frank Gore was a Colt. Paul Goldschmidt, the Cardinal? Eh, not buying it. Prismatic playbook. Whoa. The good news is you're all auto-entered. Every time you buy a spot in any break that has click it to win it or, you know, grand prize kind of stuff, every spot you buy gets you entered. And then on Cyber Monday night, I'll be doing breaks on that night. We'll draw the winners. I have a list of prizes which will be announced probably on Friday. Some cool stuff. It's usually hobby boxes, packs, hit packs, memorabilia items, autograph 8x10s, break credits. Well, yeah, the base, the prisms and the silvers, and there's like a handful of 5 to 6 dudes. Bryce Wilson, he is a Brave. Who has the Braves? Hopefully the new dude. Frankie White. I'd like to know how Garrett found TSB. Google search or my incessant tweeting? '70s Astros. Is that what that was? I think I got a straggler box of Prism sitting over here. There's a box of Prism, but I got to make sure it's not up on any other breaks or websites, but I think that might be an available straggler Prism. Well, I need to make sure that it's not in any other breaks. I don't remember what's on the website. because I think that's... I pull the brakes to the side to prevent that, but I got a playbook and a prism down there, and then a playbook and two XRs down there, which I think are the other brakes. So it looks like that can be a triple teamer, Carter. I don't think it's in any other brakes. I know we have the Black Friday brakes, but they're sending me that stuff. The Black Friday brakes, how many prisms are in that? Number 50, Max Scherzer, world champion. The Nationals. That's for Ryan Howard. It is a random straggler box. Really is. There's just one in all the mixers? Good, because they're sending me that. It's a package I buy, so that you can put that up. Yeah, the Blitz Mix. I want to make sure I'm not overselling on the Blitz Mix, so hang tight, Carter. Don't put that prism up yet, because I got to look at the Blitz Mixes. I don't want to be short. Something tells me I added prisms to the Blitz Mix Friday nights. JT Realmuto is a Philly. And he's numbered to 50. Just one. All right, they're sending me one. It's on this list, so you can post. If there's just one in those Black Fridays, post that last straggler there then. Because the Black Friday packages I bought have Prism in it. So we can post that one. Thanks for looking, dude. I don't think I've ever gotten any other color framers but gold. Please be something dope. Well, it's numbered to 25, and it's Dakota Hudson. Cardinals again. Jessica Howe. Red Dakota, 25. Make sure you put in a Black Friday campaign clicker, please, Carter. All right, well, we're in good business then, because they're sending me it. I feel like I was just here with you all. That was freaking Saturday night already. Young Cal. So someone came in the shop today, friend of a friend. He brought in, literally no exaggeration, 6 giant boxes that grown men had trouble carrying in. They were so heavy. 6 full boxes of nothing but stuff from about 1988 through 1993 or 94. Just sets, singles, like screw downs, but of course, unfortunately, it was mostly all the stuff we've all seen a million times. So it's all still here. I'm going to go through it, see what there is, but it sucks because people are like, you're telling me all this stuff isn't worth $200? I'm like, it's really not even, I don't even want to give you $200 for it, man. and you don't want to be offensive to the person, be like, yeah, I'll give you $100 for all that stuff. It's like six giant boxes full of stuff, bobbleheads and pictures, random photographs. But what am I going to do with it? If I take all that, what do I do with it then? I mean, the cards are off center. It's just, it is what it is. I feel bad, but I could have my, I got to pay my guys to go through it hourly, to take a few hours to go through it. There is a Benny. Boston Red Sox for Shawnee Mac. 75. Oh, there's probably Elways, yeah. I mean, there's a Joe Montana rookie in it, but it's like three quarters cut centered. Like, it's way off, like three quarters. Joe Montana rookie. It's literally worth $6. But there is some stuff in there that I like personally. There's like a Michael Jordan plate. Stuff that looks really cool. But value-wise, it's just not there. Personal collection stuff. Some people might like some of these old tchotchkes that are in there, but I don't know, have to figure it out. Bo Jackson. Here we go. The last card of the break, dudes. Mini mix, budget style Tuesday night. Maybe I do budget style Tuesdays every Tuesday. Would you like that? I kind of like doing budget breaks on Tuesdays because Wednesdays are usually a very big day. So, Eloy, budget meaning, I mean, the price of the product is always the price of the product, but just doing like little dual and triple box breaks. Robbie Cano. We got a rookie card. Anybody care to guess who that is? If somebody can guess who that is, I will give you the first person. I will give them two Topps holiday packs right now. Oh! If you can guess who that is. Tuesday budget breaks. Greatest hashtag ever. It does kind of look like him, doesn't it? Wouldn't that be awesome? We'd have a customer for life if it is. Who is it? No, we're trying to guess who this is, and they'll know. It's a rookie card of this person. Ooh, that's a good guess, Scotty. He says Rowdy. It's a white uniform. Any other guesses? Danny Jansen. It is a Blue Jay, though. Carter. Danny Mac. I got Immaculate, dude. What do you want? I got National Treasures. Robert. Are you referring to this Immaculate? Would that be the Immaculate you're referring to? Those are Straggler Immaculate. Stragmaculate. Listen, everybody, thank you for buying into that, helping me move out this gold label. Yo, Robert, what up? Family food, football, mixed in with fun.